work on the command prompt normally. From this point, there is something called advanced Kubernetes starts. When you start advanced Kubernetes, right, the entire configuration of the Kubernetes, deployment of Kubernetes, or whatever, we will have to manage through this YAML file only. We'll have to manage through this YAML file only. So you have to be much more familiar with the YAML in terms of working with the Kubernetes, to be honest, I can see. So, see, you know, yeah, of course, these are not part of our sessions because advanced Kubernetes, we have dedicated Kubernetes class, I told you, right, which is around 40 to 50 hours. Over there, we'll cover, but just now I'll tell you high level so that you will get some idea. Okay. So, if you guys feel like overloaded, you can avoid this particular thing. It's only I'm explaining to people who really want it and eagerly to see it. It's not mandatory everyone to know. Okay. So, when you open this deployment YAML, right, see, there's an option called deployment.yaml. You go there and open it. This is the YAML file to create your pod deployment. Okay, here there is an option called image. See, there is an option called image. Here you can provide in this configuration file, you have to specify your own customized AMI. It's an image name. When you have specified through this configuration file, right? When you have specified through this configuration file, here, see, I told you right yesterday, even two or three pod can be combined and can work for your application. See, here only we'll manage that. There is something called replicas. Replica, I mentioned like two. See, I'll maximize that. If you are giving three, right, replica, here we can provide. How can we control the port, Hari, for each and every container? So here we'll be specifying the port, container port. Got it? So when I copy this command, here we will be specifying our replica, number of pod I need to create, and port number I have to specify, and custom images, custom port number, everything we'll be doing through this deployment.yaml only. Okay, when you are creating this deployment.yaml, see, I'll show you. So I'll come out from the pod now. So what is the command to come out from the pod? Anyone tell me? So that come out, I'll execute that deployment.yaml, will show you. How to come out from the pod?
Exit in Docker.
Yeah, exit mean it will shut down and come. So same like the Docker only. So networking, coming out, the basic stuff are all common like our Docker. Control PQ, it will take you out. Okay. Fine, now what I'm gonna do, as we all know, right, kubectl get pod. We are able to see only one pod is running as of now. Now what I'm gonna do, okay, now what I'm going to do, kubectl, kubectl apply, -f mean file, deployment.yaml. In the deployment.yaml, I have specified some configuration, right? Minimum, I need three pod for running my application. These are my pod, these are my custom images, everything I have specified in the deployment.yaml file. So kubectl apply whatever available in this YAML configuration, it's going to apply. -f mean file, I'm specifying this is the file, right? That attribute -f for file. So once I hit enter, right? See, deployment has been created. All right, now you can find when you give kubectl get pod. See, totally who created, I'll tell you why it's not created. I didn't save it actually. So it's taken the old one only. Anyway, no issues. When I go for save, right, now it's got saved. Anyway, so it's taken only the old one. Anyway, no problem. If you give three, right, it will create a three pod for your application deployment. Three pod for your application deployment. Okay, see, for example, if you delete any one of the pods, so just let's see, out of these two, I am deleting any one of the pods. Kubectl delete the specific one. See, 2j I'm deleting, and I try to delete. Okay, the particular part has been deleted. Now, according to my configuration, only one should be there, right? What we have discussed in Kubernetes, if any pod goes down or any node goes down, it has inbuilt auto scaling functionality. How can we validate it? If a kubectl get pod, instead of 2j, you should be able to see another one will be created and up and running. You can find the difference in the age. both should be 9 seconds. Now you can see the latest one, what replacing, you know, 2J, it will have the limited less age over comparing other one. See, instead of RLL XJ X8 is there already, which is created 81 seconds before. This has been replaced automatically. 21 seconds before, it has been replaced automatically. So when it is creating a part, right, it will refer the same image, whatever the custom image I have provided in the script, it will bring back our configuration automatically. Okay.
Got it.
Got it, guys.
Yeah.
This is what the first level of Kubernetes would be. So in order to go deep dive into Kubernetes, right? Yeah, even we have maybe after this our AWS DevOps training, we'll study. I'm going to complete in another 4 or 5 sessions, right? 4 or 5 or 1 week hardly. After that, we'll start Kubernetes batch, Docker Kubernetes, dedicatedly for Docker and Kubernetes. We'll not discuss any other tool, nothing. Only purely concentrating on Docker and Kubernetes. You guys can join into that as well if you are personally interested. Okay. So that is a separate course actually. It's all up to you. Cost, right? Generally, people who are coming outside, third party people, we are charging up to, you know, if person, I'm not even know, is a new to iTech, is a new student, we'll be charging up to 16,000. Okay, the person who already learned iTech AWS DevOps course, who like you people, the person who ever joined, right, they will get around 40% discount from above course. Okay, actual courses, you'll get 40% discount. Actually, it'll be like 8,500 or 9,000 actually. Again, I'm going to be the trainer for that as well. Hi guys. So this is something what I need to really convey it in terms of Kubernetes. So practice up to this. Okay. So in the document, what I already shared in the group yesterday, so go ahead and have a look on this, right? Everything I mentioned in the proper screenshots. You can zoom as much as you want. If you're seeing in like this, right, it will feel like an unquality image because it's really good one. If you scroll down, you can find all the commands I have highlighted in the yellow color mark. See, actually, when production, if you are executing get Kubernetes cluster, you will getting this many cluster only. Okay, so in order to authenticate that one only, we are having running the command, kubectl update command. And here, see, I have shown everything. Creation of deployment and the creation of listing the pod, logging into the pod. Everything I have shown in this example. All the commands has been given. Okay, go through it and practice the same thing. If you have any doubt, right, I'm available today and tomorrow, for me week off only. Today and tomorrow I'll be totally free. You can call me. Okay, we'll discuss if you want.
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
And guys, I think that's it today. This Saturday we have completed 10 minutes early, 10-15 minutes early. You can go and happy weekend. And try to complete today, tomorrow itself, so that Monday we can start focus on probably Jenkins or something like that. Okay, new tool we can start focus on. Okay,